The cooking gods are smiling down on us today because we have two great chefs here with us this morning. Daniel Boulud owns 10 award-winning restaurants, including New York's Daniel. He's the author of a number of great cookbooks, including Braids, A Journey Through International Cuisine, and Thomas Keller, executive chef and owner of New York's Per Se and California's French Laundry, as well as the author of the cookbook Ad Hoc at Home. Daniel and Thomas are heading up the American team at the prestigious International Bocuse d'Or competition, and they're here to make an amazing slow-cooked lamb dish.
We're making home cooking today.
Home cooking.
Yep.
Thomas is the chef, I'm the commis, and you're the apprentice.
And we hopefully will be successful.
I wonder about this. Yeah. This is, I looked through the recipe in the beginning, and I thought, even someone who's inexperienced would have trouble screwing this up.
You're absolutely right. I mean, it's just really just need to brown off the lamb shoulder.
Here. Right.
We're going to put it in our all-clad slow cooker with our beans that we haven't even soaked.
So you don't even have to soak those overnight or anything?
No, they're good to go.
Right.
Good. So it's very, very simple.
So this has been braised in like a canola oil or something. You make sure it's all brown all the
exactly.
way around.
Exactly, right. We've just browned it off. We seasoned and browned it off. This is purebred lamb, one of our sponsors for the Bocuse d'Or, of course, right. our all-clad. And then we have our lamb stock here. We've made this, but you can use chicken stock if you want or just some water.
Okay.
A little bit of roux.
Because I don't usually have lamb stock
No, well, we're chefs. That's what we do.
Okay, so the roux,
This is flour.
Right.
And butter.
And butter, and that's it.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
We cooked it.
So mix that in with the stock.
With the stock, and then we're just going to pour the stock over the beans. And then we're going to turn our slow cooker on.
You, Thomas.
Turn our slow cooker on and put it on high for 3 hours.
Right.
And then after 3 hours, we're going to add all of our vegetables.
Right.
So we have turnips, carrots, garlic. Some beautiful fall onions,
gorgeous.
A little bouquet garni, and some tomato.
Right.
Covered up. 3 hours later, we add our vegetables.
It's really the magic of that old-clad slow cooker.
Right.
Really, will never burn the stew.
Yeah. Look at that. Can you just see this? Look how beautiful that is.
Yes,
that is absolutely gorgeous. All right.
And no fuss. You can go do something else for 3 hours, put your vegetables in. 2 hours later, you come back. You're ready to go. Five-hour total time.
We're going to taste that in a second. In the meantime, though, so interesting, because both of you are as accomplished chefs as exist in the United States. How is it that you've come together, then, to team up to help foster this competition over in Lyon?
Well, I'm from Lyon, and about 3 years ago, Paul Bocuse called me and said, you know, every 2 years in Lyon, America is participating to the Bocuse d'Or.
Right.
Most difficult competition for chefs, certainly. And he said, well, I would like to certainly have America do better. And would you be able to get involved and do something?
Mm-hmm.
So the first thing I did is I called Thomas and I said, I think Paul Bocuse, the great chef from Lyon, will call you.
Right.
And he may want us to team up to help the Bocuse d'Or in America.
So he really did throw down a challenge to
you. He wanted better teams. The phone rang, I answered it. He said, would you do the Bocuse d'Or? What do you say to Paul Bocuse?
Right.
Oh, of course, you say yes, chef. And that's what we did.
And Paul Bocuse has his son, Jerome Bocuse, who lives also in Orlando, Florida, who run the restaurant at the Epcot Center, Chef de France. And he got involved with us also. So the three of us are managing Bocuse d'Or USA.
Okay, so how do you form a team then? How do you find the right young chefs to and be in this competition?
We have a national competition. So we reach out to all the chefs in America to give us their best candidates.
Right.
And then we choose 12 of them, and they go, we had a national competition at the CIA this year, the Culinary Institute of America, and the best team won. And the best team was James Kent and Tom Allen from 11 Madison Park.
Wow.
So we've been training them for the past 8 months.
Wow.
And they'll train up until the end of December, the end of this year, and then we'll all go to Lyon. and hopefully, we'll come back with
absolutely.
Because in all the years of competition, I think no American team has won.
Right? Yet the best was Timothy Hollingsworth, the chef de cuisine at the French Laundry.
Right.
Thomas, chef de cuisine.
Came in sixth last year.
He came sixth last year with very short preparation.
We only had 4 months.
Right.
We were pushing it. So
this is like super intensified graduate school then for these guys, and then to hang out with you and be under your tutelage to go to this competition.
Well, it's like the Olympic of cooking where 24 countries compete together.
Right.
And each country choose their best chef and best commis to be able to compete. And so it really takes all the skill a chef should require to be able to win.
Very, very intensive. 5 hours to cook this competition.
Just stunning. Well, listen, we will have our eyes on the competition when it comes around. Thomas Keller, Daniel, really great to see you both.
Thank you.
If you would like to, I'm going to taste this in a second. For this recipe and more on the competition Bocuse d'Or, all you have to do is go to our website, earlyshow.cbsnews. That's right. And
there you go. That's a little,
bit of a persillade. Yes, everyone can be a donor, actually, to the Bocuse d'Or when they go to the website.
Oh, if they want to help the
support
team
the foundation, because we need to raise a lot of money in order to win.
So. Right. So come to our website, donate. And how's that?
www.bocusedorusa.com.
I'm handing over the money now.
.org.
We'll take some money from you.
There you go.